Thank you. Wonder-making hand. No miracle Where this water lies. from the wrecking crowd in the name of Jesus. Let's let say, let us say his freedoms. Let me all bow up and say, it only comes through Jesus' name. There's victory in each trying out through faith and his mighty power. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
Go through a Baptist church, meet with Miss Taylor Brown from Pikeville or Parkville. She had fun together today. And this is Chastity Fisher. She's a good friend of mine, which is an hour ago. She's the father of North Carolina's King's Cross for Free Will Baptist. She's been with a while at Tea Sunday School, but as she can lead the choir. So she's mighty pleased to make her welcome.
I'm glad to have my little girl, Sunny Lee. She's 7, and she said last night, I want to sing with you, Mommy. So I said, well, come on. We're all about it in our church. If the little ones want to get up and praise the Lord, let them do it, because they are our future. All right. Sam, come on, let's get ready.
My name is Tim Sutton. I haven't seen Pastor Haynes. I used to call him Jonathan. I haven't called Pastor Haynes. Last time, I think I saw you. You were at the Bellevue Church. You were playing basketball at GCA. It's been a long time, but he was pretty good. He was really good. So he gave us a call. I'm really glad to come up here with us. Thing now since 1988. Church, Bible believing churches, and we have 10 churches, and we'll be in our churches too. So, we'll sing as much as you do, but we're glad to be here to proclaim the name of Jesus. Amen.
Well, good morning. special because it tells the story of Jesus Christ. And I think that's one that we all, as Christians, we know very well. But, you know, there's a world out there that doesn't know. And I think as Christians, we kind of get blinded by that sometimes. We forget that maybe the person that we may work with, that we go to work, we see every day, we may talk to them, but do we ever really tell them the story of Jesus? Sometimes I think this day and time, this world as crazy as it's getting, we tend to forget that as Christians. And I think it's our time that we need to start standing up and we need to start telling everyone. Doesn't matter if they know or if they don't know. If they do know, you'll have great fellowship. And if they don't know, you'll have even better fellowship because you'll bring in another brother or sister into the fold. Just by telling this simple story of how Christ lived and then died on a cruel, rugged cross, and on the third day rose again. And I'm here to tell you that's not where the story ends, because like we said in the song earlier, Jerusalem, that is the new heaven that God has prepared for us. If we have accepted Jesus Christ as our personal Savior, we have a chance to enjoy that eternal heaven with Him.
Let this pass from me.
thankful to be saved this morning. I'm thankful for Christian parents that raised me in a Bible-believing church. And I'm thankful for the Sunday school teachers that told me Jesus loves me. You know, that's why we're here. We're here today to tell you that Jesus loves you. He loves all of us. He died for all of us. And the gift is free. All we have to do is accept that gift. And when he comes into your life, he gives you a peace and a strength and a joy that I don't know how people can have without him. You know, we all go through trials. We can start over here and come all the way around. And everyone has a story. We have family members that are sick. We have family members that are lost. You may be going through something mentally. We may have financial issues in here. We all have trials that we go through. But that's when we have Christ as our Savior. We learn to trust him. You know, God is sovereign. He's always right. You know, we go through things we might think, you know, that's not fair. Why is this happening to me? God knows why. We have to take those trials and use them for his glory. Because that's what we're here for. We're here to serve him and to serve others. Because that's what he did when he was here on earth. It's my prayer today that if you're waiting for a miracle to happen, you give your burdens to God. Give them to him. Because we can't serve him if we're carrying all those burdens. Let's give them to Christ this morning and let something amazing happen. You know, his grace is sufficient for everyone here this morning. He loves you. Whatever you need, trust God and let something amazing happen this morning. You can enjoy the words of this song. Standing on the edge of losing everything. You're out of options, out of hope. You've lost your way. You're happy ever after. It didn't turn out like you planned. You're searching for a solid place to stand. Looking at the ashes of one could have been. Can't help wondering if you finally reach the end. Yet in this place of weakness is when miracles begin. Watch and see the dead can live again. This is where amazing happens. This is where God steps in. This is the place where broken dreams can be again. When you're to the end of hope, nowhere else for you to go. Welcome to the place of second chances. This is where amazing happens. Dawn can never come unless there's been enough. And healing cannot come without the rule of life. And mercy's only